Hello and welcome. I am Tahir from tocreateablog.com. Today in this video, I am going to show you how you can easily transfer your live website to Localhost. If you want to develop your website locally, you want to make some changes and test the code, you can transfer your website to Localhost very easily. I am using Linux, but it doesn't matter if you are using Linux or Windows Localhost. The process is same. Here you can see this is a live website at WP Engine. Now I'm going to export or transfer this website to my local host. So this is a live website at WP Engine. And here you can see I have localhost/WP. This is a local website. Now I'm going to transfer this website to localhost. So you will have to go to your dashboard and you need to install a plugin. It's called All-in-One WP Migration. This is a free plugin available at WordPress plugin directory. To install this plugin, simply go to plugins, add new page and search for All-in-One WP. Then install and activate this plugin. After activating this plugin, you will have to click export link because we want to export this website to localhost. Now click on this export to option and choose file. Now it will check some settings and then it will create an archive. Now you can download this archive. After downloading this archive, you can close this page, close this menu. Now you need to visit your local host. So go to your local host dashboard and install this plugin here. I have already installed this plugin on my local website. Now you will have to click import option because now we want to import our website. So now select file and now I downloaded this archive, so I want to import this archive. Now it is checking extensions compatibility and you can see this warning message: the import process will override your website including the database, media, plugins and themes. Please ensure that you have a backup of your data before proceeding to next step. Now I want to proceed. It will take some time. Now you can see this message: your site has been imported successfully. Save permalink structure opens a new window. So yes, now we need to save our permalink structure. Let's click update WordPress database. Click continue. Now I need to log in. So now you need to use your username and password that you have been using for your live website. Now you need to select permalink structure and click save changes button to save your changes. Sometimes you need to save your changes twice. Now you can also see this message: you should update your .htaccess file now. So if you see this message, you will have to update your .htaccess file on your local system. I have already published a video, but I will show you how you can do this locally. Now let's visit front end of our website. And now you can see we have successfully imported our website from live environment to local environment. This is our local website. You can see this address: localhost/WP. And if you visit front end of our live website at WP Engine, you can see this is the live website. So you can see this address: tcap2.wpengine.com. And this is our local website. So let's visit blog page, contact us, about us, pricing table. So you can see everything is working fine. But in your case, you might see some problems. So due to permalinks, because you can see this message or this information: if your .htaccess file was writable, we could do this automatically, but it isn't. So these are the mode rewrite rules you should have in your .htaccess file. So now I'm going to copy these rules. I am using Linux, so I will show you the Linux way. So let's go to file system. Now I need to go to opt, lamp, then htdocs directory. Now here you can see my WordPress directory and here you can see .htaccess file. So you can right click anywhere and choose open terminal here. Now I'm going to delete this file. Now to create HTML file again, you can use this command sudo space touch and then file name. In my case, file name is htaccess. Now our file has been generated. So now we need to open this file in nano text editor and I have already copied rules, so I will use Ctrl plus Shift plus V keyboard shortcut to paste this these rules. Now I need to press Ctrl plus O to save my changes. Now hit enter and press Ctrl X to exit, and that's all. Now we have successfully created .htaccess file on our localhost. So after saving your changes, you can go back to your WordPress dashboard, save your changes again, and now everything should work fine. So this is how you can easily transfer your website from live environment to localhost or from localhost to live environment. The process is same. Now if you want to transfer this localhost website to live environment, process is same. You can you can install all-in-one WP migration plugin on both of your local and live website. Now to transfer a local website to live environment, you will have to visit export page on your local website, then export your file to export your website to file and download this file. After downloading this file, visit your live website and go to your dashboard and your live website, then all-in-one WP migration and click import button and then import this file. So this is how you can easily transfer your website from localhost to live environment or from live environment to localhost. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, please subscribe our channel for more WordPress and blogging related videos.